Right. I guess, you know, my team fought so hard. You know, you can't let your team down when, you know, you fight so hard. And this whole season we've been fighting through adversity, and, you know, that was a chance for us to get over the hump. So that was my opportunity to make a change for this team, and that's what I did.
What were your, you know, what?
Right. My teammates had my back. Farmer, D'Lo, and Kurt kept patting me on the back and saying, just do what you do. And that's what really helped me get to where I wanted to be. And, you know, I was able to execute and make plays. So just play Georgia baseball. And that's what Coach Perno has been trying to emphasize to us. You know, we can't get outside our brand of baseball. And that's what we did the first game, and we executed every play. You know, defense played very well to our capability, how we always play. And we was able to make plays and make things happen, get a win. It meant a lot. Basically, it's going to carry on till tomorrow so that we'll be able to win the series tomorrow. So
feel it right now, but, you know, it feels all right. It's getting better as the days go on. But, you know, it was a tough game today. I mean, first game was awesome. We had great team chemistry the first game, and then we came out the second game. You know, it's pretty tough to come back from 5 runs mm-hmm. in the first inning offensively, especially with BD on the mound, who's probably a number one, you know, first rounder this year. And but, you know, I thought, you know, we played well decently. I mean, we played decent the rest of the whole day, but, you know, we've got to come out tomorrow and get the series win. It was huge. I mean, it took a lot of pressure off, and, mm-hmm. you know, we that's the team who we really are, was the first game. You know, we pitched well. Jared Walsh did an awesome game, and we hit the ball well. We had a lot of walks, and, you know, that's the team that we want to be, and that's what we'll become. In the second game, it just kind of dozed off, you know. But that first win, it's always good to win, I guess you could say, on a Friday night, but the first game. The first game, I was so impressed with the pitching. I mean, Jared Walsh came out there and threw a gem, and then I think Dylan Cole, Jarrett Brown, I forgot who the other guy was, but they threw awesome. And, you know, the second game, it was just, you know, that stuff kind of happens, you know. I mean, every game counts for us now. I mean, every game we have to win to get into that SEC tournament, which is our goal. And it's also good for confidence. I mean, they're number two in the country. And so if we come out with a win tomorrow, the sky's the limit for us.
Left field, Hunter, and Justin were phenomenal in that double play. They had runners on the corners in the seventh with nobody out. And Benzer got a soft pop-up, and we were able to turn that double play at the right time. It was a great win for us, a great game. And it was just disappointing the way we started the second game, because Patrick's been pretty good for us, at least getting us off to a good start. And you know, he just didn't give us much of a chance today.
What can you do
better than, you know, getting in there and losing late or giving it up? So, you know, you sit there, the guys played hard, we hung in there, but we just, you know, you can't spot the one of the best teams in the country 5 in the first. I mean, it's just, that can't happen. And unfortunately it did. And but our guys never backed down, and I was proud of Farmer. I mean, I know no one's touched Beatty like that all year. They hit 2 home runs off him in one game, and so that was extremely positive, because he looks like he had a great day. We had some guys that had good days, and we had some guys that they got beat up a little bit offensively, but hopefully they'll respond tomorrow.
Well,
it was the matchup.
Yeah.
They were at the top of the lineup, and their 1 and 3 hitters were left-handed. And I know Jared is calm and cool and can handle, just give him the ball. So we switched it, went with Dylan in the 8th and Jared in the 9th. Well, they took a real good player out of their lineup, and the guy they inserted had 8 at bats, and he hits a 3-run homer in the first. And you know, so yeah, that's, give them credit. But our guys did a great job in the first game. Even Walsh got all the tough outs. He didn't give us the length we wanted from him, but Diedrich was solid, Benzer was solid, Cole and Brown, and you know, that's why this game we didn't use any of those guys. Had to use them again. If you use them again, then they're done for the weekend. But now they're still available tomorrow. We just need to get off to a good start. Well, I think considering where we are and what has transpired up to this point, and just the adversity and the struggles and the, you know, just the injuries and everything, if we can just find a way in there, we've done it before where we had to, you know, win some games just to get in the postseason. I like this group to get a shot. I really would. They have done what we've asked. They've played hard. They haven't, as tough as it's been at times, they have stayed the course, and they believe that they can do some good if we can get there.
And with JT Phillips, is there any news on his status or anything like that?
Oh, yeah. No, he's not with us, that's for sure. I mean, just the thought that, the night before the biggest doubleheader, and, he puts himself in a situation like that, he doesn't care about this team or this program, and so he's dismissed.
Dismissed from the team?
Oh, yeah, certainly.
I mean, how disappointing is that for him to do that, before you have a noon start on a doubleheader? I mean,
yeah,
obviously
that's why it makes it my decision easy. I mean, and I think our kids could care less. They're disappointed too. Mm-hmm. So it's, it's just unfortunate, and it's probably why we've sputtered as much as we have, because we've had some guys that just haven't been with us. They're just front runners and don't have what it takes to be successful at this level. And, I hate it for JT, but, it's just, he made it too easy.
So JT is dismissed?
Oh, certainly. Okay.